Hello students, how are you all? So today we will start with our class 9 biology and we have already started with chapter 5, the fundamental unit of life. In that we have started with the components of cell. In that we will study about the various components of a cell by which the cell is made up of and what are the functions of each and every part of the cell. And in that we have started with the plasma membrane. So, across the plasma membrane, the movement of particles takes place and we have started with the two types of movement. One is diffusion and second is osmosis. So, diffusion we have discussed already, osmosis also we have started, but I will repeat it again because the next topic is related with the osmosis. So, what is osmosis? The process of movement of water or water molecules from its high concentration to its low concentration through a semi-permeable membrane is called osmosis. I have shown you one picture also in the previous session, in the previous video. There were two solutions A and B. Out of the two, how will you find that which is having more water concentration as compared to the other? So for that you have to see how many solute particles are there in the solution. In this case, we will see that water will move from its on higher concentration to its low concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable means which allow only solvent molecules to pass through it, because water is a solvent. Because you know that in a solution, there is a solvent and there is a solute. Solute is the solid particle and solvent is the liquid particles. So, semi-permeable membrane is must for osmosis to takes place. Okay, so this is the definition of osmosis. You should be very clear, you should be very careful while writing the definition of osmosis. You have to mention here that water movement from its on higher concentration to its low concentration and through semi-permeable membrane. Without semi-permeable membrane, osmosis is incomplete. Okay, so on the basis of that, there are various three types of solutions on the basis of concentration. So, I think you all are clear with the concentration. What is concentration? Let me tell you again so that it will be more clear to you. For example, we have a solution. Okay, if we are saying that we have a mixture of water and sugar, so that is called solution. So, we have this water in it and sugar particles in it. So, this is a sugar particle and these are water molecules. So sugar will be considered as solute and water will be considered as solvent, and this together will be considered as solution. So is it clear? The solution is the mixture of solute and solvent. Now what is this term concentration? Concentration means how much amount of solute is present in the solution. Means you can calculate in a form of percentage. Like if we say that a solution has 10% concentration, it means that its 10 parts is the solute and 90 parts is the solvent. Okay, so it means 10 grams of sugar is present in the solution. So it is always represented in the form of concentration. And on the basis of this concentration, there are three types of solution: hypotonic solution, and isotonic solution. Now, what is this hypotonic, and isotonic? Actually, we have compared the concentration of solution with the concentration inside the cell, because cell also contains a solvent inside it in the form of water as well as solute particles. So, inside the cell, there is some concentration because they have a mixture of both solvent and solute. Okay. So, on the basis of that, we have compared the concentration inside the cell and outside environment of the cell. On the basis of that, we have three types of solutions. We will take up one by one these three types of solutions. So, let's see the three types of solution on the basis of concentration: hypertonic, hypotonic, and isotonic solutions. So, hypertonic is the one in which the medium surrounding the cell has low water concentration than the cell, which means that if this is a cell and this is the medium which is surrounding the cell. Obviously both will have water inside them. So if we compare the water concentration of the medium with the cell, then you will see that the outer surrounding medium has low water concentration as compared to the cell. Means cell has more water as compared to the surrounding medium. That is called as, this solution is called as hypertonic solution. This you have to be this should be clear in mind, that the solution is called hypertonic, not the cell. We are just comparing the concentration with the cell. So here the surrounding medium has low water concentration as compared to inside the cell. So if the water concentration is low here and the water concentration is high here, so what will happen? I have shown the arrows inside as well as outside, because there is always the exchange of water molecules across the cell. In the medium in which the cell is surviving, there is always a movement of particles as well as water molecules. So these water molecules will move inside and outside as well, because there is a difference in the concentration. But the net movement of the water molecule will be outside the cell because of low concentration of water molecules outside the cell. So this solution which is surrounding the cell having low water concentration is called hypertonic solution, and there will be net movement outside the cell due to which the cell undergoes shrinking. The cell will shrink. In the second case, that is called hypotonic solution. So the medium surrounding the cell has high water concentration than the cell. So this is the surrounding medium outside the cell, and this is the cell. Both have some concentration because both have some solute as well as water particles. But here the concentration of water is high and here the concentration of water is low. And you know that the movement will always takes place from high water concentration to low water concentration. So I have shown you here arrows, two arrows inside and one arrow outside, because as I have already explained you that there will be movement of water inside as well as outside the cell, but due to the difference in concentration the net movement of water will be inside the cell, because the water has less concentration inside the cell, due to which the water will, more and more water will enter in the cell. The cell will undergo swelling, that is the cell will swell up. So this surrounding medium having high water concentration is called as hypotonic solution. Now let's see third one, isotonic solution. So this is the surrounding medium and this is the cell. So we will see that in both the cell as well as surrounding medium, the concentration of water is exactly same. That is why I have put two arrows here. One arrow inside and one arrow outside. It means that the number of water molecules going inside the cell is exactly equal to the number of water molecules going outside the cell. So there will be no net movement of water molecules and there will be no change in the cell. So are you clear with the three types? Because it is very very important topic. On the basis of that, there are the different two types of osmosis also we will take up in the next topic. But it should be clear first, then you will be able to understand the next one. So is it clear? Hypertonic means when the surrounding medium has low water concentration than the inside. Hypotonic means when the surrounding medium has high water concentration as compared to inside of the cell. And isotonic means when outer surrounding medium as well as inside of the cell have same water concentration. In this there will be net movement of water molecules outside the cell, due to which the cell will undergo shrinkage. Because क्या होता है, अगर किसी भी चीज में से water निकलता जाता है तो वो shrink हो जाता है. And in this case the water is going in and inside the cell, so the cell will swell up. But in this case both the movement are outside and inside is same, so there will be no change in the cell. And related with this, we have two activities in your book also. We will discuss the activities also, that will make you more clear regarding these three types of solutions. Okay, so we have discussed about the types of solutions on the basis of concentration and movement of water molecules. Similarly, on the basis of movement of water molecules, there are two types of osmosis, endosmosis and exosmosis. So endosmosis is the movement of water molecules inside the cell when it is placed in hypotonic solution. As we have already discussed that hypotonic solution is that which have low water concentration as compared to the cell. So when the cell is placed in hypotonic solution, the net movement of water will takes place inside the cell. That process is called as endosmosis. Endo means andar jana. That is why we have discussed here that movement of water inside the cell is called endosmosis. In this case, the cell will swell up. Obviously, when the water will moves inside the cell, then the cell will undergo swelling. For example, it's a very general example that you can see at your home also. Like sometimes you keep the raisins in water, you just soak the raisins in water overnight, and in the morning when you just see the raisins, they get swell up. Okay, so why is that so? Due to endosmosis. Because when we keep the raisins in normal water, then the concentration of that water will act as a hypotonic solution for the raisins, because inside the raisins the water concentration will be low, so it will undergo endosmosis and raisins will swell up. Okay, and the next one is exosmosis. It is just reverse of endosmosis. Exo means exit. It means when the movement of water molecules outside the cell when it is placed in hypertonic solution, because you know that hypertonic is a solution which have more water concentration as compared to cell, due to which when the cell will placed in hypertonic solution, there will be net movement of water molecules outside the cell. So the water molecules will leave the cell, due to which the cell will undergo shrinkage. For example, when we keep grains in a hypertonic solution, we can make hypertonic solution by mixing salt salt with water. You can use high concentration here, means you can use a extra amount of salt to mix in water, a glass of water, and then you can keep the grains inside that. You will see that after some time the grains will undergo shrinkage because of the loss of water from the grains, because we have placed it in the hypertonic solution. So these are the two types of movements of water molecules when they are kept in different solutions like hypertonic or hypotonic, and this will be called as endosmosis and exosmosis. So this endosmosis and exosmosis or water movement in the living world where it is being used like by various organisms, by cells, let us see here where it is used. Okay, so as we know that the water molecules move through endosmosis and exosmosis. Now let's see what are the uses of osmosis in case of living organisms. For example, like there are some organisms, unicellular freshwater organisms, amoeba and paramecium, all these they gain water by osmosis. Okay, so they intake water by the process of osmosis depending upon the type of solution present outside them. Next is plant cells also. They gain water by osmosis, that we have already discussed, that plant cells, they take up water by osmosis. And next one is very important point, that is absorption of water by plant roots. So you know that the roots of the plants, they take water from the soil. So soil will act as a surrounding medium for the cells inside the root. Like this is the cell inside the root, and the soil will act as a surrounding medium, and they will absorb water by the process of endosmosis, because you know that soil, when we give water inside the soil, then the water concentration inside the soil will be more as compared to the plant root cells, due to which the water will move inside the plant root cells by the process of endosmosis. So that will be an important point, that absorption of water takes place by plant roots through endosmosis. Okay, so this was all about osmosis, that the types, the definition and the types of solutions. Next is, as we have discussed about the movement of gaseous particles by diffusion, solvent or water molecules by osmosis, Now, what about the solid particles? Because it is not like you only gases or water will move inside or outside the cell. There are solid particles also, food particles also, that have to move across the cell. How do they move? On the basis of their movement. Their movement is called cytosis. So the movement of solid or food particles is called cytosis. And there are two types of cytosis, endocytosis and exocytosis. So endo means अंदर जाना, एक्सो मीन्स बाहर आना, एक्सिट होना. तो द मीनिंग इज सेम, बट हेयर वी विल डिस्कस दैट द मूवमेंट ऑफ सॉलिड और फूड पार्टिकल्स विल टेक्स प्लेस हेयर. लेट्स सी इन केस ऑफ अमीबा, बिकॉज यू नो दैट अमीबा दे टेक्स वाटर विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑस्मोसिस, बट वेन दे हैव टू टेक फूड पार्टिकल्स, देन वेन द फूड पार्टिकल कम्स नियर अमीबा, देर विल बी अ स्यूडोपोडिया फॉर्मेशन अराउंड द फूड पार्टिकल्स. यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट the pseudopodias are basically for the movement as well as for collection of the food particles. So when this food particle it comes near to the amoeba, then the pseudopodias will be formed around it, and due to this, after pseudopodia formation, the membrane from both the sides it will fuse like this, and later on you can see this vacuole like structure engulfing the food particle. So this is the food particle and this is the vacuole which is carrying this food particle. So this process is called as endocytosis, because here the food particle has been engulfed by amoeba. Okay, now after digestion, because amoeba also they have to digest the food particles, which is a complex food for it. To make it simple, it will undergo digestion, and after digestion the undigested or waste particles which needs to come out from the cell will be released out in the vacuole also. So this is also a vacuole. Vacuole is like when we will discuss in detail, then you will be more clear what is a vacuole. It means carry some particles inside it. Okay. So this vacuole will then fuse with the membrane of amoeba and will release out these waste particles. So here we can see that there is an exit of the waste particles. So this process will be called as exocytosis, because here the waste particles are in the form of solid. So these are the two types of movement of solid or food particles. So this is all about the movement, the types of movement across the plasma membrane. Now we will see, and these two are only possible because plasma membrane is flexible in nature, and you know that it is made up of phospholipids and proteins. And next we will see there are some two activities related with the osmosis process given in your book. We will discuss now the two activities.